So let's have a look at the string section. The string section of the orchestra consists of violins, violas, cellos, and double bass. Did you know the violin is the highest of the string instruments and it is made from wood? It has a range of 5 octaves and the violins play more notes than anyone else in the orchestra. It is not the loudest of instruments, which is why you need so many of them in the orchestra playing together. To make a violin, you need over 70 pieces of wood. The most famous violin maker was Stradivarius, and his violins have sold for over £9 million. The violin has 4 strings, G, D, A, and E, and you use a bow to pull along the strings to make the sound. Famous violinists include Nigel Kennedy, Nicola Benedetti, Itzhak Perlman, and Andrew Rieu. Here is Nigel Kennedy. That was Nigel Kennedy playing The Winter from the Four Seasons. An amazing violinist, and as you can see, a violinist can play incredibly quickly, and it was making all of the sort of high sounds for the orchestra. Now we're going to move on to the viola. Did you know the viola is similar to the violin, but it is slightly larger, and it plays the middle range of notes in the orchestra? It has a range of 5 octaves, but a more mellow sound than the violin. To make a viola, you need over 70 pieces of wood. The viola has 4 strings, a C, G, D, and A. So the C string is a little bit lower, but the violin has an E string, which is higher. And you use a bow to pull along the strings to make the sounds. Famous viola players include Nicola Paganini, Paul Hindemith, and Kim Kashkashian. Here is a clip of the viola. As you can hear, the viola sounds a little lower than the violin and a little bit more mellow. The cello. Did you know this is a large instrument, too big to fit under your chin, so it has a spike that comes out of the bottom and rests on the floor, and you grip the cello with your legs. The cello plays the low notes in the orchestra. This is known as the bass line. The cello is made over 70 different pieces of wood. The cello has four strings, C, G, D, and A, the same as the viola, but they are a lot lower. The cello also has a range of five octaves. Famous cellists include Yo-Yo Ma, Julian Lloyd-Webber, and Jacqueline Dupré. This is a short clip of the cello. As you can hear from the clip, the cello is very, very low. The double bass. Did you know? This is the largest instrument in the entire orchestra and is taller and wider than a grown man. To play it, you have to sit on a high stool. It is really big, as the instrument makes the lowest of all the notes in the orchestra. The strings are about 2 meters long and are really thick to make the low notes. There are over 70 different pieces of wood needed to make the double bass. The double bass has a range of four octaves. The four strings are E, A, D, G, but they're set up backwards from the violin. Famous bass players include Willie Dixon, Giovanni Bottesini, and Domenico Dragonetti. Here is a little clip of the double bass. As you can hear, the double bass is very low and very, very tall. And you could see how thick the strings were, so it could make those low notes. The harp. Did you know, the harp is one of the oldest instruments in the world and is believed to have existed 15,000 BC. The word harp comes from the German language meaning to pluck. The orchestral harp is about 6 foot and has 90 separate strings. There are pedals on the harp to make this easier for the harpist to play in different keys with an orchestra. The harp has one of the largest ranges in the orchestra, covering over 6 octaves. Famous harpists include Lorena McKinnitt, Carlos Salzado, and Joanna Newsom. Here is a little clip of the harp. Thank you. As you can see, the harp has lots and lots of strings. The string family is the largest family in actual numbers of the orchestra. The string family has the five members, and to make the sound of the string instruments, you must use a bow on the string. Sometimes you can pluck or strum the strings. I'm now going to play you a little clip of the string family together. You might recognise the conductor of this group. And that was Mr. Symonds conducting at the Royal Albert Hall with his string orchestra. As you can hear, it sounds very, very powerful when all the strings play together. But for now, we shall leave the string family and we will head to the woodwind. The woodwind family. Over the years, this family has grown a lot in the orchestra. But today, I'm going to talk about the four main instruments: the flute, the oboe, the clarinet, and the bassoon. So let's start with the flute. A flute is technically any open tube that you blow into to produce sound, even an empty bottle of Coke. A flute playing musician is called a flute player, a flutist, a flautist, a flutter, or a flutinist. The flute was one of the first musical instruments ever invented and has been used for thousands of years. Ancient Sumerians, Egyptians, Greeks, Indians, Chinese and Japanese all used early versions of today's flutes. Many different cultures have their own take on the flute, and many of them developed independently from one another. The major Hindu deity Krishna holds a bamboo flute. It is being said that Krishna created the world through the beautiful sound of the flute, and that the flute preaches love and freedom. The standard concert flute has a range of about 3 octaves. The flute is one of the highest pitched instruments, consequently flute music is written in treble clef. The piccolo is basically a mini flute and sounds 1 octave higher than the standard concert flute. When piccolo players play flute music, the notes sound 1 octave higher. Throughout history, flutes have been made of bone, ivory, wood, jade, glass, plastic, brass, nickel, silver, gold, or even platinum. Now let's hear the flute. Just how high the flute can go in that clip. Now let's move on to the next instrument. The clarinet is a long, thin wooden tube, really, and it's got metal keys running all the way down it. You blow into a special wood mouthpiece. Attached to that wooden mouthpiece is a very, very thin piece of wood. It's thinner than a piece of paper. And when you blow, air gets trapped in between that thin bit of wood and the thick bit of wood, and it vibrates. And that's what makes the noise. And that's why the clarinet is a woodwind instrument, because you're blowing into a piece of wood. So let's hear from the clarinet. So that was the clarinet. Let's move on to the oboe. The oboe is similar to a clarinet. It's a long, thin, wooden sort of tube. But this tube is thinner than the clarinet. The other difference is the mouthpiece. The oboe has two very thin pieces of wood bound together with a little bit of sort of cotton or string at the top. Those two thin pieces of wood are about the same thickness as a piece of paper, and they meet at the top. And when you blow, air gets trapped in between them, and it makes the pieces of wood vibrate together really quickly, move up and down, and that causes the sound of the oboe. The oboe sounds a little bit like a duck, and it can really penetrate through the whole orchestra. So let's have a listen to the oboe. Let's move on to the last instrument, the bassoon. The bassoon is a very long piece of wood. It's hollow inside, so there's a hole all the way through it, and it's really very, very wide. This size of instrument allows it to play all of the low notes. It's called the granddad of the orchestra because it sounds quite old. So let's have a listen to the bassoon. As you could hear from the bassoons, because they're so large, they make the low sounds of the orchestra. Now let's move on to the brass family. In the orchestra, you have four main brass instruments: the trumpet, the trombone, the French horn, and the tuba. The trumpet is the smallest one and makes the high sound, and the tuba is enormous and makes the very low sounds. Let's find out a little bit about each instrument. A trumpet is a brass instrument used mainly in classical music and jazz music. The most common type of trumpet is a B-flat trumpet, meaning that if the player plays a C, it will sound a B-flat in concert pitch. The trumpet is played by blowing into the mouthpiece and making a buzzing sound. There are three keys called vowels that the players can press to change the pitch. A brief history of the trumpet. The trumpet has been around for about 3,000 years. An early example of a brass instrument like a trumpet is called a shofar, which is still used in religious ceremonies. Eventually, people started making trumpet-like instruments with wood, for example, the cornetto, and later with brass. Modern bugles are similar to early metal trumpets. The trombone is a brass instrument capable of producing sound that is rich and brilliant, lower than the French horn but not as low as the sound produced by a tuba. The trombone was developed from the trumpet common in the medieval era and was documented in Ferrara court records in 1439. The Duke of Burgundy had a trombone player at his wedding in 1468. During the Renaissance and Baroque eras, the trombone was referred to as a chèque-bouse or sackbut. It was lacking in some of the features of the modern trombone, but it had a double slide which allowed for lower scale sounds. The sackbut was the first musical instrument to have a moving slide. The French horn is a musical instrument originally of the wind family. Horns were originally truly horns. People would blow into an animal horn to produce sound. However, eventually this shifted as the ability to make horns from metal emerged. The earliest horns were simply brass tubes with a flared opening. The addition of valves did not happen until the 1800s, and until that time, changes in pitch were only achieved by the lips of the person playing the horn. It took a while for the use of valves to catch on. The French horn debuted in Paris in 1664 in the comedy ballet titled La Princesse de l'Élysée. The French horn is now in the brass family because it's made from metal and the mouthpiece is metal as well. Tuba. The tuba is the lowest pitched and largest in the brass family of musical instruments. The tubist, or tubaist, creates sound by blowing into the large mouthpiece, which produces vibration in the instrument, and then uses their fingers to press the valves to produce different sounds. The tuba was invented by Johann Gottfried Moritz and Wilhelm Friedrich Weyprecht, who were granted the Prussian patent number 19 in September 1835 for their bass tuba in F1. In 1838, the first tenor tuba was invented by Karl Moritz and Johann Moritz's son. Most tubas are made of brass and they can be left unfinished, which must be polished to keep from being tarnished, or plated with silver, gold, or nickel. Now we move to the percussion section. The percussion section has hundreds of instruments that it could possibly play. However, today I'm going to talk about the main four standard instruments. They are the bass drum, the xylophone, the snare drum, and the timpani. The bass drum. The bass drum is a large drum-shaped instrument in the percussion family that produces a low pitch when struck with a mallet or beater on a pedal. The earliest version of the bass drum was the Turkish davul, tabul turkey, that existed in the 1300s. In the mid-1700s, many of these drums were brought to Europe and soon became a popular addition to military bands. The Turkish drums were played with a rod and a wooden drumstick, but when they were introduced into the orchestra by Spontini in the 1800s, they were played with mallets covered in felt.
Absolutely amazing. I had no idea that one could produce sounds like this on bass drum.
It becomes bigger and bigger and bigger on the stage. It's this fire-breathing dragon.
The xylophone. The xylophone is a musical instrument with wooden bars that are struck with a mallet to produce sound. The wooden bars are arranged similarly to a piano, and each one is a different length, which creates a different sound. It is believed that the xylophone dates back to ancient Southeast Asia, 2000 BC, and that the instrument was brought to Africa by Malayo-Polynesians. The Western xylophone, which is the one most are familiar with, is first mentioned in Europe in 1511. It was referred to as wooden clatter at the time. It wasn't until the 1860s that the term xylophone was used to reference the instrument. The snare drum. The snare drum is an instrument in the percussion family that is considered a main part of the drum kit and is found in a variety of bands. The snare drum is usually played with a drumstick and can be found in concert bands, marching bands, parades, drum lines, and in rock bands and modern music. The snare drum is also referred to as the side drum and is the smallest cylinder drum. The snare drum is derived from the tabor, which is a drum that was originally used for accompanying a flute. The snare drum has two heads, and most often they are made of plastic, but some are made of calf skin. The drummer hits the snare drum head with a drumstick or beater that can vary from brushes to the drummer's hands. And finally, the timpani. The timpani are instruments of the percussion family that is also often referred to as the kettle drum. It was introduced to southern and western Europe in the 1200s, and they spread north soon afterwards. These first timpani were pairs of kettle drums and remained in use until the 1500s. The larger version of the timpani spread in popularity across Europe in the 1400s. Over the next few centuries, variations emerged and the aristocracy used them along with trumpets as signalling instruments. When gunpowder was invented, the kettle drum was not needed for signalling, but remained as an instrument, used for festivals and in church music, and it eventually made its way into the orchestra music and modern music of today. We are really lucky in our area that we have two of the oldest orchestras in Great Britain. We have the Slawick Philharmonic, which happens in Slawick, and the Huddersfield Philharmonic Orchestra, which happens in Huddersfield Town Hall. Slawick is an industrial village in the beautiful Combe Valley near Huddersfield in the West Riding of Yorkshire. Here, a group of amateur musicians met in 1891 to found a philharmonic band. In its long history, it has experienced both triumph and disaster, but for some years now, it has enjoyed uninterrupted success. Recognised by the award of the National Federation of Music Societies Sir Charles Groves Prize in 1993, and a Performing Rights Society Enterprise Award in 91 and again in 96. Each season, the 80-strong orchestra gives 4 concerts in Huddersfield Town Hall, and further concerts in other venues, including their home venue of Slawick Civic Hall. Its conductor from 1969 to 2001 was the late Adrian Smith, who was also the orchestra's historian and publications editor. Adrian was succeeded by Chris Holding, who made his debut with the orchestra in January 2002. In October 2008, Benjamin Ellen was appointed musical director. Under Benjamin Ellen's direction, the orchestra's reputation for bold and adventurous programming, as well as championing repertoire often neglected by professional orchestras. The 2016-17 season was the Slawick Philharmonic's 125th anniversary. In 2008, Mr. Simons, yes me, was the leader of the orchestra for 3 years. The Huddersfield Philharmonic Orchestra performs concerts 5 times a season, either in Huddersfield Town Hall, Dewsbury Town Hall, or Huddersfield Parish Church. They bring together a mix of players, young and old, from the town and surrounding areas who share their talent and love of music with each other every week. This orchestra is more than 150 years old. This is the end of the Guide to the Orchestra. I hope you have enjoyed learning about the different instruments and the sounds that they create. If you feel inspired and would like to play an instrument, please tell your teacher so we can sort out a form for you to take home. Thank you and enjoy your music.